If you want to create beautiful, engaging graphics for your social media or business, but don't want to spend too much time learning a complicated app or hiring an expensive designer, I got you. In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to use Canva in around 10 minutes. Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I share super actionable ideas on content creation for entrepreneurs and creatives. And in today's video, I'm sharing how to use Canva in around 10 minutes to start designing your own graphics for social media or other business purposes. If you've not heard about Canva, it's a free graphic design tool perfect for creating social media graphics, presentations, posters, or other visual content. It's so much easier than Photoshop and many other graphic design apps and gives you tons of beautifully designed templates to transform your brand image. When you watch this video, you'll learn all the basics to start designing by yourself. And if you need an in-depth tutorial, I've got one published on my channel already, so you can check it out here. All right, on to Canva. First, let's go to canva.com and sign up for a free Canva account. Click on this button here, and you can sign up with Google, Facebook, or sign up with your email. You can also use my link down below to start off with Canva Pro to test out some of the amazing features, and it's going to give you a free account for 30 days. So this is what the homepage looks like. You have the top panel with various navigation tabs to showcase different Canva functionalities. And then there's the search bar, which you can use to quickly find what you need, and the account settings in here. In the left panel, you'll find your designs, folders, and other personal resources. And in the middle, you've got multiple Canva templates in different categories like social media, events, marketing, documents, etc. What I would start off with is setting up your brand kit with your brand colors, fonts, logos, if you obviously already have them. The brand kit is a Canva Pro option only, so if you don't have Pro, then you have to choose the right colors and fonts manually each time. But it shouldn't be a big problem because Canva shows you the recently used fonts and colors when you're designing. And of course, it's an extremely useful feature to make your progress effortless, so I'd start off here. So once that's set up, we'll go ahead and create our first design. So you can either create a design by hitting this button, search for a particular type of graphic in the search bar, or click on the ones that Canva recommends already. I'm going to go for the button here, and you can use custom dimensions or choose a specific project, like an Instagram post, for example, and it will automatically pick the best dimensions for you. So naming your design first is quite a good habit, so let's do it now. You can just click in here on the top and start typing whatever you want. So I'll start with Spring Break Instagram Post. And that's done. So as with the homepage, the editor is quite similar in the layout. You've got the top panel with the different navigation options and the exporting options in here, the left panel with the different functionalities, and the main editor, which I'll go through while we start designing. So you can start designing by using one of the Canva templates created for this dimension specifically from this panel to the left in here, or you can start from scratch, which I'm going to do just now. So let's change the background color first. I'll select the background, go to the top in here and click background color. And then you've got the different options. So you've got default colors proposed by Canva. You've got the main color palette, which is actually my palette, which I added to the brand kit at the very beginning. Then you've got document colors, which displays all the colors that have been used in this particular design. And then you've got the new color option, which if you click on it, it shows up this little screen in here. And you can play around like this to choose something that you like or enter a specific hex code. But I'll go with main color palette in here and use my baby blue one. So let's add some photos to the design first. So as you can see, when you go to the photos, it displays the different trending ones. And when I scroll down, I actually don't see anything that I would like to go for. So let's search for something springy because it's a spring break post. Let's scroll down, and as you can see, when you hover over an image, it shows you if it's a pro element or if it's a free one, like this one. So if you've got a pro element, that means that you'll actually have to pay for it if you don't have a pro account. So let's scroll a bit further, and I actually like this image in here. So I'm thinking I can actually use it as a background as well. So let's rotate it. It shows you the 90 degrees in here. Let's drag it by the corners. And this now acts as a background, just like this. And when you click on it again, you see that it actually kind of cropped to the background in here. And obviously when it's selected, you've got the different top options at the top as well. So you've got the different effects, which you can remove the background, which wouldn't really apply to this particular image. You've got filters, you can adjust the brightness and various different sliders in here. You can crop it, or you can flip it as well. So I can flip it vertically or horizontally like this. So next, let's go and add some text to the design. Let's click in here in the left panel. And as you can see, I've got different fonts added from the brand kit, but you can also use the pre-set up font combinations from Canva. So let's see what I've recently used. So let's use this one. I actually really like the way it looks and how it flows with this particular post. And as you can see, when I clicked, it added a group of different texts with different fonts. So let's hit in here on group, and that will separate all the different layers. So you've got this one in here with Play for Display, you've got this one with Glacial Indifference, and then this one with Glacial Indifference, but that's probably a different one. So let's say Happy Spring Break, and you can actually make it bigger by dragging it like this, or you can just adjust the size in here. So let's select these two like this, drag them down just to separate them from this particular one, and I can actually make it more narrow in here. And as you can see, when I'm trying to move that particular one, let's move this one to the bottom in here, and this one in here, I can actually just get rid of that bottom one like this, and we can select the two. And if you go to position, you can align elements perfectly using the pre-existing Canva align elements. So you can click on middle, and that will take it straight to the middle. But as you can see, I had two elements selected, so that one went to the middle as well. So I can just drag it down in here like this. And as you can see, this solid line appears in the middle. So that means I'm right where I need to be, right centered in the position in here. And let's change the color of this particular element. So maybe let's go for this dark blue for my main palette, and this one as well in here. But this design lacks something. So let's go to elements and find something that we can actually use. So if I go to elements in here, you've got all the different types of elements that Canva offers. So you've got frames, which you can put photos into. You've got shapes, which can add a bit of definition, and lines, different lines as well. So let's maybe start with a line. So I've added this line in here. First off, again, let's change the color. Let's drag it down here. And as you can see, you've got different options for the line. So you've got line weight in here. Let's make it thinner, maybe not as thin, but see 3. And you've got the different types of lines in here. So you can make it dashed, you can make it dotted, you can make the ends of it a bit more rounded, and you've got a classic line in here. So maybe let's put it at the top in here, and you can just drag the ends of it to make it look a bit like this. But actually, I don't love this particular one, so let's search for a different element. So let's type in rays to maybe find something like a sunshine, something to add a bit more to the design, but still keep it on theme. And I actually really like this one, so let's click on it. It's got the completely wrong color, so let's change the color in here. You can make it this nice blue in here, but obviously it's a circular option, so you can click crop, and I can just make it half. And this way I'll have a nice element like this to add on top of my design. So let's put it in here like this. And as you can see, when I dragged it, it actually kind of grabbed it and put it with this dashed line, which means it's aligned with the element below, which is the Happy Spring Break text. So this is how you would navigate in Canva. It's really intuitive, and Canva helps you out to align different elements, photos perfectly. Let's play around with the colors. I like to keep it quite monochromatic, so let's stick with that particular one. And you can select these two to maybe drag them a bit lower like this. So let's say we want to make this design a bit more interesting, so we can actually animate it. So let's add animation. If you click on animated here, you see all the different types of animations that it can actually give you. So you've got fade, pan, rise, tumble, drift, all the different ones, and some of them are only available for Pro. So let's choose fade for this one. And if you click on here, you can actually adjust how long you want this animation to last. So I'll pick 10 seconds and you can view it like this in here. I'm happy with this one, so let's close it now, and I'm ready to actually export it. So if you want to export it as a regular post, you can go to PNG. This would be my go-to format to actually do it. And you can just hit download and it will start downloading in the bottom in here. And if you want to export it so that it shows the animation, you would have to choose the MP4 video or maybe a GIF, but let's go for the suggested one in here. Let's download it. And again, you can see the MP4 video rendering, and then you'll be able to download it. Brilliant, so that's me done. I've got the two different designs. I've got one PNG file, which is a simple graphic, or I can use the little video to maybe add a bit of oomph to my blog post. If you want to know more about Canva, check out this comprehensive tutorial here. And if you'd like to learn some of my top tips and tricks, watch this video next. Hit that like button, subscribe to my channel for more content like this. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you being here. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.